Ladies and gentlemen, Team Liberty disagrees with the narrative that skill-based education is the panacea to unemployment in Nigeria. Skill-based education involves the compulsory incorporation of skill acquisition schemes into our curriculum, and it is quite notably not different from what is obtainable in the status quo, where individuals can subscribe to a variety of skill acquisition programs like Trident in the United Kingdom and the National Industrial Training Scheme in Nigeria. Two false assumptions implicit in the motion are that individuals are unemployed in the status quo because of an inadequacy of skills, which is not true because individuals are skilled in the status quo but they still lack jobs. Because unemployment is caused by the strangulation of a lot of companies and inability of the government to create a lot of jobs necessary for these people. Second assumption is that people having acquired skills are automatically employed or employable, which is not true because we know that we have a shortage of skills. And secondly, the variety of skills available to the market actually requires individuals to subscribe at an independent level.
Finally, skill development is very cost dependent. The fact that people are taught be many doesn't necessarily mean that they do not have individualized preferences that they would want to do that do not intersect with be making. So a lot of people will choose to remain unemployed even after going through this compulsory skill-based education.
Ladies and gentlemen, in addition to the narrative already raised in the house, we feel that for some basic reasons, this argument on the other side of the house does not hold in today's debate. One, because we feel that it takes oversight of factors like corruption, which is capable of hampering the progress and success of this kind of system. We feel that even the best ideas can suffer from corruption. Secondly, we feel that this system is not sustainable because the nation does not at present have the resources to sustain the system. If we can start, I feel we cannot be able to finish because it demands a lot of capital, both to refurbish the primary, secondary and tertiary institution. And finally, we feel because of the inability of people to adapt to changing technologies because they do not have certain programs to update their skills in this kind of technologies, this program will come short and its effectiveness will be denied. If instances like this take place, people will be dropped out to the labor market and they will not be effective. Thank you.